Okay, sorry, I'm just very excited. Guys, I'm getting my very, very first chemical peel. About to be looking silky smooth. Hi, friends. So, today for this vlog, we have a chemical peel. Honestly, recently started getting facials because I recently found a black esthetician in my area, and that even got me overjoyed. So she recommended, after going to her for a few different times, she recommended a microneedling appointment, and I did that a few weeks ago. And if you guys want to see like the microneedling results, I'm pretty sure I have them on my TikTok. And now I'm going in for my first chemical peel, so I'm excited to see how much I'm going to peel and just kind of that experience. I know some people have said while you're getting it burns a little bit, so I'm a little nervous about that. I'm hoping it's not burning as much. I'm gonna finish getting ready and then we're going to head straight to my chemical peel appointment. So I'll see you guys over there. All right, we made it. I should have showed y'all how it was raining, but I never realized the definition of it's raining cats and dogs until I came to this date, man. But we're here.
So while you peel, that's pretty much exfoliation. So you won't be using any of that. I do have some like, you know, sensitive skin stuff like CeraVe, Cetaphil, like. But yeah, so for the week, try to avoid like direct sunlight.
Okay.
Try to avoid using hot water on your skin.
Okay.
Like when you shower, because just as you know, just to not have any dehydration or anything.
How long after the chemical peel can you work out?
I would say like once you're completely done peeling, like your skin doesn't feel dry,
okay.
You don't see any more shedding skin. So with the first peel, like I said, people rarely ever see any to like very little. Every skin type is different though.
Mm-hmm.
So, and you will like, you know how your skin feels. So if it feels like you start sweating when you work out and like you feel some tingling, okay, like there's still some exfoliation going on.
Okay.
The forehead, and we'll work on this side.
Okay.
That'll be one pass. So depending on how you take, you know, how you respond, we'll do more. And then tighten your lip for me. Perfect. First pass. Any tingling?
No.
Okay. One of my favorite things with a chemical peel is people love getting it before an event because your skin is like crazy glowy. It's like a natural glow.
Mm-hmm.
Are you feeling it on this area here?
No, not as much. I feel it more right here.
Okay, yeah, because now it's setting in. Where you apply, obviously the peel becomes stronger, so I'll just give it a second.
Okay.
It's common for you to have like dryness around the mouth. I mean, that's where the mucous membranes are, so we lick our lips and whatever.
Mm-hmm.
So you can, if you have like, I put like a balm in there, like this kind of like a lotion balm, like Aquaphor, similar.
Okay.
You can put that like in the corners of your mouth and the corners of your nose.
Okay.
Because I know sometimes it'll feel dry, especially the mouth part.
Feels like my upper lip is itchy.
Yeah, it feels like tingly too. Yeah, like you want to scratch it.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's another part. Little white section here.
Mm-hmm.
It's like right here. It's easy for me to see. It's hard to see in the camera. But it's called blanching. That's when the skin, once the acid pretty much hits the skin, it starts to kind of separate from your epidermis.
Mm-hmm.
And it looks like that, which is what we want, really. Like you want a good exfoliation, so that's a good sign.
Okay.
It's like a frost. Probably frosting too. This is gonna definitely frost because
4.5. Okay.
Four and a half. So we'll do one more.
Okay.
And then that will be it. And then I'll do some LED. The red light is like pairs perfectly like after chemical peel. In case like if you're white, obviously your face would be red right now from exfoliation. But it helps like it calm any irritation down.
Okay.
So I love doing the LED after. Only a few minutes of it. Last one?
Yes.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how would you say?
More so like around the mouth area, right here. And then right here, probably like a 6 now.
Okay, yeah, we're done. Well, you did good. You did good. Sometimes people can't go past 1. Like everyone's skin type is different. The skin feels tight and tight, right? Not really?
Not really.
Okay, I'm gonna put the LED on with this bare face, and then once the LED is done, then I'll moisturize and do some moisturizers on it.
Okay.
Feeling tingly?
No.
Okay.
My cheeks are a little red. They feel a little irritated. But besides that, I don't feel any dryness. This is a few hours later. I came straight home, so she told me I did not have to wash my face again. I feel like I look very shiny. But other than that, everything is fine. So far so good. It's only like a 2-3 hour update after the facial. I think I'm gonna give you guys an update tomorrow on how the skin is going and possibly how I wash my face as well. She gave me a gift, like a goodie bag of all hydrating like samples for things to use. I already have a lot of hydrating products here, so I may not use them, but we'll see. I'll take you guys with me when I wash my face in the morning.
Okay. Good morning, guys. So I'm running a little late before I want to go back to bed. This is my skin so far, a day after the chemical peel. She's doing pretty good. I don't see any issues. I did feel a breakout near my lip. But other than that, she's looking fine. Don't have any peeling. She just feels a little dry. But I'm about to wash my face. I'm going to be using a lot of my hydrating products this morning. I can show you quickly, actually, the little products that she had given me.
I do like the shine that I have on my forehead and my nose. I feel like it's very, ooh. Will it stay? Sorry, my face just feels dry. So she gave me a little skincare kit. Usually after you book with her, she has a kit from PCA that's already set and ready to go. But I guess PCA is pretty backed up, so she wasn't able to get a kit from them. All right, so let's get into the products that she brought me, that she kind of sampled for me. So right here, she gave me a soothing cream. And she said a lot of my peeling, if I don't peel all over my face, a lot of my peeling and my dryness is gonna come from the crust of my mouth and then the crust of my nose. Then she gave me an oat gel moisturizer. I do have a face wash from Aveeno, so I don't know if I wanna use that today or I can just continue to use my La Roche-Posay. Damn, there's no R in it, Denise. And after the P, La Roche-Posay. I only use moisturizing or hydrating face washes in the morning before benzoyl peroxide anyway, so I have two options with that. Then I have, she gave me the Cetaphil. I can't speak this morning. She gave me the Cetaphil Gentle Face Wash.
I feel like I used Cetaphil once in my life and it really didn't work for me. But she gave me actually two. And then she gave me an oat restoring cream. Ooh, we might actually try this. I have three good face washes in here that my esthetician gave me for samples to continue my healing process for my chemical peel. So no active products. If y'all need to screenshot this, you can screenshot this. I also have my own products that I will be using. And let me show you my products. I'm not going to take you guys through how I wash my face today because it's going to be very, very simple. And I'm not peeling yet. I will take you guys along when I actually do start to peel. I'm excited to peel. So this girl better peel. Specifically down here, please. And thank you. So I can look like a rock star for the month of June.
Boom, baby. It's way too early for all that. I'm sorry. Okay, this is day two of the skin. I haven't washed her yet. She's not giving me lizard or reptilian skin yet. However, I think she's gonna get there. I see like skin wanting to shed a little bit more on this side, and this was a problematic area for me for the past couple of months, so I'm hoping she does what she needs to do. Hey, yo, I'm not even gonna hold you guys. If my wig slides back, if it slides completely off, just pretend you didn't see it and continue watching the video and don't. Anyways, I'm getting some peeling and like, I don't know, like around my mouth area, but she said that's pretty common. So I'm not that excited. I didn't think I would be this excited to peel, but all like the progress videos that I be seeing from people, they look tight. Like they look good. They look good. So I'm excited to see how it's gonna look. I want it to look like a baby's bottom. Valid? Now, the only thing I don't know is when can I start slowly introducing my regular products back into my routine? And I don't know if I could just hop back to my original routine or if I have to slowly introduce the products that I've been using. But my esthetician is really good about answering my text messages. Well, I text her literally from about everything. Besides the fact that when I want to experiment and maybe buy tools that I probably shouldn't buy on YouTube. If you guys watch my vlog, I had a scab on my face. And it was because I was trying to extract some whiteheads and I pushed too hard. And she was explaining that to me. And also she was low-key but very nicely flaming me because I bought the tool and then I told her about it instead of asking her if that is a good tool to buy. Right now I'm just going in with my Aveeno. I usually wash my face for like that 60 second rule. I absolutely love them. I just do the 2 month subscription because I run out of them very quickly. And then we're just going to go in with her and then my sunblock, even though I'm staying inside all day, I still put sunblock on. So we're going to go in with her. And then after that, our day is done. I mean, hold up, because it's only 7:30. Our day is not done, but our day for our morning routine is done. I'm just going to brush my teeth, go take my vitamins. And then unfortunately, we have a 9 to 5 to get to. I.e. it's in the other bedroom. The skin is done. Thank you guys for getting ready with me. She's not peeling right now because I just hydrated her. I'll give you guys an update. I'm only going to give you guys an update if she starts giving me the reptilian skin that I want. So I will maybe see you guys tomorrow if I get an update. But if not, I'll let you guys know. Bye. But I told you I was going to give you guys an update if I was peeling, and the most peeling I had was when I spoke to you guys about me doing my skincare routine and washing my face in the morning. That was really it. That's all the peeling I got. I do have a follow-up with my esthetician today. I think I'm either doing a hydration facial or red light therapy. I thought I would break out a lot more because I've seen some horror
stories about chemical peels that got your girl a little scared. I'm not gonna hold you. But I actually didn't break out too much during the peeling process. I just thought I was gonna peel a lot more. And let me give you guys a better view of what I see on my face.
All right, Betta. I can't find my cocoa butter chapstick, so we gotta use the Aquaphor. I don't really like this one. I like that it has SPF, but if it accidentally gets into my mouth, it tastes disgusting. It does not taste good. I feel like in different lighting, my skin always looks either worse or better than it is, but I can't tell whether this is the everyday lighting I'm gonna see and I'm gonna assume that my skin looks nice, or if I back up and the lighting is the lighting that I see every day, if that's the lighting that I see that you see that I'm gonna see, so I notice that my skin looks horrible. You picking up what I'm dropping?
What? Bro, what are you talking about, man?
Anyways, I'll give you guys an update when I go to my appointment and get the facial. So we'll see then.
I'm peeling around the chin. Very light flaking. But this is good because it also shows that your tolerance is good. Okay. So the next one will go even deeper.
So it's on there. I actually love the idea of getting a peel and I'm not like crazy stripping. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah, I've seen like a lot of the
videos. Yeah,
there's different types of peels.
I was like, am I gonna look crazy? No. But it didn't look that bad.
No, don't look bad at all. And this is only the first of a few times. It's gonna take more than one chemical peel, you know?
Okay.
And this is just a gentle cleanse.
Facial is done. I'm going home. I'm going to bed. I'm tired. But she told me to come back. We have a hydrating facial scheduled for 3 weeks from now. So that's it for now. I won't be doing another chemical peel or another invasive face treatment until I get back from my vacation. So in like maybe July. But that's the chemical peel update. I was really hoping I was gonna peel more, come on. But so far, she's not bad. She got potential to be better. But thank you guys for spending this little skincare vlog with me. My journey with my chemical peel. It wasn't a bad one, because I got scared. I did get scared. All right, bye guys.